So does this look normal to you? Is there any reason you might want to shoot this way? Well, there is, and I'll tell you about it after the intro. So why would you possibly shoot with a red filter over your lens? Well, put up a chair, sonny boy, and let me tell you how it was back in the good old days. See, when we used to shoot black and white film, you could put different colored filters like red, yellow, or green in front of your lens to make specific tones go lighter or darker. The way you know what each color does is just remember that the filter will lighten its own color range and make the opposite colors go darker because it blocks that light out. Red gels were often used for landscape images because it made the blue sky go darker, which adds contrast and drama to your images. Now, the big question is, in today's digital world, would you still want to shoot with a color filter? Well, the main reason to do it is because you'll spend a lot less time in front of the computer. If you set your camera on the monochrome picture style, then what you see is what you get. So you can make adjustments to exposure or contrast right in the camera and you're basically done. However, when you shoot in RAW and convert to black and white in the computer, you can simulate the effect of a color filter with way more control. So don't just convert your image to grayscale, but use the black and white adjustment sliders in Lightroom or Photoshop, or a specialized program like Silver Effects Pro, and you'll see how each color affects your final image. Change the green filter to make trees and foliage go lighter, while the red filter can darken a blue sky. Also, by working in the computer, you can change your mind later and reprocess the image, even in color if you want. So listen, I'm the type that likes to get things right in camera, and it's still fun to experiment with a red filter on your lens. But learn to work with those color sliders in your computer, and you'll be able to make awesome black and white images, maybe even better than we did in the good old days. So hey, come back here next week for another 2-Minute Tips episode on Adorama TV. Follow me on social media, @David Bergman, for information about my upcoming live workshops. See you then.